Anaka Hospital has an average monthly admission of 2,893 patients. This gives the hospital a large number of daily admissions and a hectic schedule for the health workers.
At any time, and you have to come and do the work. In case of an emergency, call at 2, 3, 4, depending on the time, because with the CSIT, it doesn't call. Any time your mother is in labor and there is difficulties, there is some emergency, you are called to come and work.
But over 40 essential health workers have to risk their lives every night in order to provide services to these patients. Stella Grace Awoh works in the surgical theater, and she has to risk a boda-boda ride through the dark and cold nights in order to conduct surgeries during odd hours.
Twice I was attacked on the way, but God willing, I survived. So it's really not easy. It's very difficult. It makes our work very difficult. Some of us are almost giving up, like we want to go to the unit where you're not called at night. 15 minutes to reach the hospital. It is not easy, quite challenging.
Of the 214 staff at Anaka, 154 are essential health workers, but the hospital does not have enough houses to accommodate all their health workers. Those who choose to stay within the hospital premises stay in deplorable, hot and insecure houses made of iron sheets with cracked doors.
It's normally challenging when it rains, because you have to fight for the time. You need to report by 8, and then it means if it rains, it becomes very hard, because you need to come and work at that particular time.
This has made health workers to dig deep into their pockets in order to rent houses outside the hospital premises.
Don't even save, because the place I'm renting, it takes me per month, it's 160,000. Then I have like children to pay school fees, so I find it very hard. I don't save money.
A decent house in Anaka Town Council requires one to pay at least 100,000 shillings each month, but landlords here require a rent payment to be done 2 months in advance.
Staff, you could not house them. This is the hospital also was built so many years ago when the population was low and also the staffing norm was low. But now this were, as time went on, were revised and now cannot hold all the number of staffs available. Staffs have to be, they have to rent outside.
This has put a substantial financial pressure on the shoulders of these health workers. A lack of funds has been blamed for the deteriorating housing facilities of the health workers at Purongo, Lungulu, and Anaka hospitals.
These health workers have to commute from outside to come and attend emergencies at night, putting their lives and that of their family at risk.
Okot Samuel Obonyo is the Nwoya Assistant District Health Officer. He is further concerned that poor housing facilities could expose the health workers to respiratory infections.
Health workers are already sick at home, and they are coming to help those who are sick. That is not fair. Our staff, I think, across the sub-region, I know the problem is much, but specifically in Nwoya district, our staff are suffering.
The situation at Anaka Hospital was made worse after heavy winds blew off the rooftop of the staff quarters in 2019.
I hope that these staff quarters will contribute towards the motivation of healthcare workers to do the best work they can do for our communities.
On the 21st of November 2022, Total Energies handed over a refurbished 12-unit building of staff quarters to the hospital.
We stand together with our communities. We stand together with local government officials who work hard to serve our communities.
Anaka Hospital is the biggest health facility in Nwoya District. It serves the other neighboring districts of Pakwach, Oyam, and Amuru. I'm Joseph Omagoro, reporting for the news in Nwoya District.